Daddy says I can't have any snacks for dinner.
Right, okay.
Poppy?
Ah. Hey, Mom. Hi, sweetheart. What are you doing?
I'm bored.
Well, did you do the things that you were going to do today?
What things?
Well, I had asked you, remember, to clean up your yarn. You made a big mess. Sweetheart, come on.
I don't want to do that.
Come on, just...
Dad, come on, play a game with me.
Sweetheart, I've asked you to do that one important task. You have to clean up your mess, and when I'm done reading the Bible...
Why? Father?
Fiona, I'm really busy, sweetheart. Look,
I'm busy too. I need to talk to you. And you know why? Because I want to know why I'm going to do everything around here, everything, and nothing that I want to do. Why?
Fiona.
What?
Young lady, your behavior is unacceptable.
Your behavior is unacceptable.
I'm talking. And now you're going to listen. You've gone too far.
No!
I see you being rude to Cooper and teasing him.
He's bullying me!
I also hear you going into the refrigerator without permission. I also notice that you keep coming here back in time again, even after I've asked you to clean your room, and you don't clean your room.
But why do I have to clean and clean?
You
and
are
clean.
Pushing the limits too far, and that is enough. And you will have a timeout. You need to go to your room now for 5 minutes. You're on a timeout.
No, why? No timeout.
Fiona, every time that you argue with me, you'll get more time. Now you have 10 minutes. Now you have 11 minutes.
Is it time yet?
Fiona, the timer's done. Sweetheart, you can come out now. Please come and see me.
Hi.
Hey. Hi, honey. Hey, I'm glad you're here. I just need to talk to you about some things, okay? So I had to send you on a timeout because your behavior was just way out of line.
Mm-hmm.
For a young lady like you, you know better, sweetheart. You just do. And I don't ask that much of you, and you just need to be able to follow the directions that I give you. That's all. It's very easy without you being defiant and rude and, you know, kind of yelling back. It's really not like you.
Okay. I'm sorry.
Well,
I'm sorry.
I know you are, honey. And now I just need to see you change your behavior. Lately, you've had an attitude problem. Have you noticed?
I don't know. I'm always bored. I'm home. We can't go out. And it's like, you know.
Yeah, I know, honey. There's a lot going on right now. And being home and being away from your schoolmates and all that kind of stuff, it's really hard. I know. And it's hard trying to teach you online, too. Real hard.
Mm.
So, I can't wait till you guys can go back to school.
Okay.
So, I get caught up with the Bible finally, and I wanted to let you know that I was reading in Philippians. And you know, there's a really great verse that I'd like to share with you. Do you mind?
No.
Okay, it's Philippians 2:14. And it says, "Do all things without grumbling or questioning." What does that mean?
That you just need to obey without talking back?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's it. And it's a really godly thing to do. It's right here in the Bible. Philippians 2:14. Do all things without grumbling or questioning. You know, I noticed you've really been questioning a lot. And instead of doing that, if you were to just do the things you were asked in a very simple way, I could have been done with the Bible a long time ago. You could have been done cleaning your yarn out of your room.
Okay.
And by the way, I heard you in your room going on and on about yarn. Mm-hmm. It's just another example of your attitude. But anyway, I don't want to bring this all back up. I know you apologized and I accept, okay?
Okay.
So let's keep going.
I love you.
I love you too, honey. Mwah. Okay, can I read one more verse? Because I thought it was really important too.
You gonna share it?
Yeah, and maybe I can share it with the kids at church. What do you think?
Yeah, where are the kids?
They're right there. You see them? Just wave. Hey, guys.
Hi, guys.
Yeah.
Hi.
Anyway, thanks for joining us, guys. And today, Fiona and I are trying to just kind of demonstrate some things by showing you, you know, examples of things we don't want you to do. But also, we are trying to find really great support in our Bible to help us and remind us of how we should behave.
Mm-hmm.
And we should behave like who, Fiona?
Like Jesus.
That's right. Can I read this verse?
Yeah.
Listen to this. This also comes from Philippians. It's 4:9.
Okay.
And it says, "Those things which ye have both learned and received and heard and seen in me, do. And the God of peace shall be with you."
Nice.
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
Jesus wants us to do godly things, honey.
Yeah.
And it...
Because Jesus is nice.
That's right. What else is Jesus, honey?
Kind.
That's right.
And he has self-control.
Exactly.
I want to be like Jesus.
Well, we all do, honey. And we all fall short of that, but we have to keep trying, don't we?
Yeah.
Each day.
Okay, Poppy. Thank you, okay?
All right, sweetheart. Mwah. All right, guys, thank you for joining us today. We hope that you understood the message today. We want you guys to do godly things. We want you guys to respect your parents and your grandparents and your teachers and the adults in your life. And we also just want you to try and reach out to Jesus in times like this. These are great times for prayer and also great times to talk to your parents about things that are bothering you. And I know there's things that are bothering Fiona. And she and I are going to talk about that later.
Okay.
All right, guys.
Bye.
Bye for now.
Into a dance. where there's lots of room, and I never would have seen it if I wasn't rolling with you.